When I started working on getting this car back on the road, there were three main things I needed to do. I needed to fix the front suspension for the super shimmy. You've seen those videos. Since it had been sitting for several years, I needed to clean out the fuel system. You've seen those videos. And then I needed to get the engine and the oil system put back together and in the car and run it. The engine work was done over two distinct periods, so we need to jump out of sequence. Before I show you working on the crankshaft, to a little bit of history of the car. Here's the timestamp the history of the car with me begins. Here's the timestamp the sequence of the build. Here's the timestamp where today's video begins, assembling the crankshaft to put it inside the case. I hope you enjoy.
History of my 1972 SuperBeetle. I bought it in July of 2006. Over the winter, I replaced the starter, but other than that, for the next year and a half, 2006, 2007, I drove it about 4,000 miles from sort of 2007 to 2010-ish. I only drove it about 200 miles, but I did a whole ton of work. New drums, new brake system, washer system, gas tank, and I ended up rebuilding the top end and replacing the oil pump. I drove it about 1,000 miles, retorqued the cylinder heads, put it all back in. From 2011 to 2012, I drove it about 3,000 miles, including a couple of thousand mile trips, the end of the second of which I realized that something was horribly wrong, and so I took the car down to figure that out and repair it.
The problem was that the brass gear that drives the distributor drive shaft, this brass gear that you see here on the left, got all torn up. They're supposed to look like this, symmetric on both sides. The one out of my car looked like this. The crank bearings looked like this, all full of streaks of brass. I needed a full top-to-bottom engine rebuild,
which ended up leading to a very long hiatus. The blue is what I did to the car. The green check marks are videos I made about that work. Now in 2019, I got back to that project, prepped the heads, I made the video. In April of 2020, we moved house. I tried to get the car running before we moved and failed. Before we moved, I got the engine bottom end built and then just the rest of the stuff all thrown back together in the car and had it towed. Two videos in 2020 about the engine bottom end, about the bearings and the crankshaft.
The build footage was from the old house, but the intro and outro were from the new house.
In the new house, I started working on the front suspension videos, so those are the suspension teardown and the bushings. In 2021, three more videos about VW sort of miscellaneous tool stuff. And in July of 2021, all this stuff got done and filmed, but I haven't put out the videos yet. Later in 2021 and into 2022, videos about the suspension, about the gas system, the videos in late 2022 about putting the suspension all back together. Everything here is in sequence, but a bunch of the stuff for the engine bottom end build
didn't have videos made about them then, but this video and the next several in this series will fill that work in.
The case and putting the cylinders in and all that stuff until the engine is ready to go in the car for the move, and then
back in sequence in the new house,
start doing the engine top end, the engine assembly, the engine install, and the oil filter system.
Now, today's video is the crankshaft buildup. Start with a bare crankshaft. Do one more bearing check in the case, which I've already done a video about. Number 4. Number 3. The left side of number 2. Bearing number 1, the thrust bearing. 3 and 4 go on the back end of the crankshaft. Bolt on the flywheel as an assembly stand. I already made a video about installing the number 3 bearing, the camshaft drive gear, and the distributor drive gear. Install number 1. Install number 4. And the oil slinger with its woodruff key. In the case for some final alignment checks. Notice as I turn the crankshaft clockwise with my right hand, the camshaft rotates and the distributor rotates. The alignment between these pieces is vital, and if it's wrong, the engine won't run. To check that alignment, I am positioning cylinder number 1 for top dead center of the compression stroke. Its throw of the crankshaft is
up out of the case, which is to the right in the engine. The cams of the camshaft for that cylinder are flat, which means that both the valves are closed, and the distributor arm is pointed up, which is to the right on the case, which is where it is when cylinder number one fires. Rotating the crankshaft backwards. If the lash was too small, the camshaft would walk up out of the case when I did this. And checking the lash by wiggling the two against each other, there was absolutely no play, so the clearance is perfect. Using feeler gauges here to set the end play shims for the flywheel. Torquing down the flywheel a little bit to get an accurate thrust position reading. The flywheel shims go on after the case is together, so I document very carefully which ones I need to put on and put them in a bag. With all the measurements and checks done, it is finally time for the connecting rods. Loctite. Three stages of torque. Make sure it moves nice and smoothly. Then peen the nuts in place, which took me quite a while because I had never done it before. Now on to the other three connecting rods. Final check to make sure that the connecting rods move nice and smoothly. With the connecting rods positioned as they would be in the case, the pads on the connecting rods should all be up. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Some close-ups of the connecting rods because they amuse me. Connecting rods positioned so that it's ready to go in the case for the last time.
I hope you enjoyed that video where we jump back to the beginning of the engine build. I hope it inspires you to work on your own car. Do so if you can. I hope you stick around for the whole sequence. Drive a manual transmission car if you can. Drive safe and never stop figuring stuff out.
Hi.